Now I show you shift reduce parsing formalized for parsing as deduction. I will do this really quick because it's basically the same as you've already seen. So here we have our axiom rule. As you might remember, we are again starting with an empty stack, and we now have the index that says how much of the input string we have already seen, and at the beginning this is 0. Then we have our reduce step. Here we have the big gamma, which can again be an arbitrary combination of non-terminal and terminal symbols. And as for some reason, gamma is preferably used for the stack. Then we have here alpha, which is the right-hand side of one of our production rules. And if this is the case, we can exchange those right-hand side of the rule by the non-terminal of the left-hand side and put it at the same place onto the stack, while whatever the index is here, it will just stay the same. Then we have our shift rule. There we have anything on the stack, and we will take the next terminal symbol from our input string. We will put it onto the stack at the end of the stack, and we will increase our counter by 1. That's the shift rule. And then the goal item: a parsing is successful if we are left with a start symbol on the stack and if we have seen the whole input string. So that means the counter or the index, or however you like to call it, is the same as the length of our input string. So here we have the parsing table for our shift reduce parsing. Here we are starting with our axiom, with the empty stack at the beginning and index of 0. Then we are performing several shift steps, each one at the previous line. There you can also decide about, theoretically speaking, you could decide about the order, because shifting is cheaper for the parsing algorithm, but reducing will more likely lead to a successful trace. So in this case, it performs all shift steps at first, then onto line 4, we have those A and B at the end of the stack, which is the same as the right hand side of this rule. So onto line 4, we can perform those reduce step and exchanging those A and those B, which are those A and those B, and we are exchanging them by the S, which is the left hand side of the rule. Then we are again shifting from line 6, our last terminal symbol from the input, which in this case is the B, and then we are left with ASB on the stack, which is the right hand side of this rule, and we are exchanging it by the left hand side, which is our start symbol. And here you have our goal item with the start symbol as only symbol on the stack, and you have seen the whole input string, which is for our input ALBB is 4. And here the parsing was successful.